Today we're going to cover twosections and line graphs, which are both types of ordinary graphs that can be constructed from a hypergraph. First, the twosection of a hypergraph is an ordinary graph with the same vertex set as our hypergraph and with the property that two vertices, v sub I and v sub k, are adjacent when v sub I and v sub k share an incident edge in the hypergraph. Remember that the definition of adjacency between a pair of vertices in a hypergraph is that there exists an edge that they are both incident to. So another way of describing the twosection of a hypergraph is that it's an ordinary graph built on the same vertex set as the hypergraph and in which two vertices are adjacent when they're adjacent in the hypergraph. As an example, what's the twosection of this hypergraph? First, generate the vertex set of our twosection. Next, find the adjacencies between vertices. In the hypergraph, vertex A shares an incident edge, E sub 1, with vertices B and C. So in the twosection, vertex A will be adjacent to vertices B and C. In the hypergraph, vertex B shares an incident edge, E sub 1, with vertices A and C, and shares an incident edge, E sub 2, with vertices D and E. So in the twosection, vertex B will be adjacent to vertices A, C, D, and E. In the hypergraph, vertex C shares an incident edge, E sub 1, with vertices A and B. So in the twosection, vertex C is adjacent to vertices A and B. In the hypergraph, vertex D shares an incident edge, E sub 2, with vertices B and E. So in the twosection, vertex D is adjacent to vertices B and E. Finally, vertex E in the hypergraph shares an incident edge, E sub 2, with vertices B and D. So in the twosection, vertex E is adjacent to vertices B and D. We're all done. This is the twosection of our hypergraph. Notice that for hypergraphs without empty edges, each edge in the hypergraph is a click in the twosection. In this case, each edge is a maximal click in the twosection, and each maximal click in the twosection is an edge in the hypergraph. However, it's not always the case that every edge in the hypergraph is a maximal click in the twosection, or that every maximal click in the twosection is an edge in the hypergraph, as you'll see in the following example. The twosection has a maximal click, A, B, C, D, that's not an edge in the hypergraph. And none of the edges in the hypergraph are maximal clicks in the twosection. We'll look at this interesting relationship between maximal clicks and hypergraphs in a future video, but for now, let's move on to our next type of ordinary graph that we can construct from a hypergraph, line graphs. The line graph of a hypergraph is an ordinary graph whose vertex set consists of the edges of the hypergraph, where two vertices are adjacent if their corresponding edges in the hypergraph have a non-empty intersection. That is, they have a vertex in common. If you remember the definition of edge adjacency in hypergraphs, we can describe the line graph of a hypergraph to be a graph whose vertex set consists of the edges of the hypergraph and in which two vertices are adjacent if their corresponding edges in the hypergraph are adjacent. As an example, let's find the line graph of this hypergraph. First, find the vertices. Next, link two vertices when their corresponding edges in the hypergraph have a vertex in common. In the hypergraph, edge E sub 1 shares a vertex, B, with edge E sub 2. So in the line graph, vertex E sub 1 is adjacent to vertex E sub 2. In the hypergraph, edge E sub 2 shares a vertex, B, with edge E sub 1, and a vertex, D, with edge E sub 3. So in the line graph, vertex E sub 2 is adjacent to vertices E sub 1 and E sub 3. In the hypergraph, edge E sub 3 shares a vertex D with E sub 2 and shares a vertex E with E sub 4. So in the line graph, vertex E sub 3 is adjacent to vertices E sub 2 and E sub 4. Finally, in the hypergraph, edge E sub 4 shares a vertex E with edge E sub 3. So in the line graph, vertex E sub 4 will be adjacent to vertex E sub 3. This is the finished line graph of our hypergraph. Moving on, let's take a look at an important theorem relating line graphs to two sections. The theorem is that the two section of a hypergraph is isomorphic to the line graph of the dual of that hypergraph. In other words, taking the two section is basically the same thing as taking the dual and then taking the line graph. To see why this is true, remember that the edges of the dual correspond to the vertices of the original hypergraph, and that a pair of edges in the dual are adjacent when their corresponding vertices in the original hypergraph share an incident edge. By the definition of line graph and two section, this means a pair of vertices in the line graph of the dual are adjacent precisely when their corresponding vertices in the two section are adjacent. So the isomorphism from the two section to the line graph will map the vertex V sub I in the two section to the vertex in the line graph, X sub I, that corresponds to it. Let's look at an example now. Feel free to pause the video and find a dual of this hypergraph yourself. Here it is. Next, take the line graph of this dual hypergraph. The vertices will correspond to edges in the hypergraph, and they will be adjacent when their corresponding edges share a vertex in common. Feel free to pause the video and finish this line graph yourself. Here's the finished line graph. Finally, let's go back to the original hypergraph, find the two section, and compare. The two section will have the same vertex set as our original hypergraph. Also, each pair of vertices will be adjacent when that pair was adjacent in the hypergraph. This is our result. Comparing the two section with a line graph of the dual, we see that they have the same structure, and that mapping the vertex V sub I in the two section to the vertex X sub I in the line graph of the dual is an isomorphism. By a similar argument, we could show that the line graph of H is isomorphic to the two section of the dual of H. Intuitively, the dual of the dual has the same structure as the original hypergraph. So if we take our theorem statement and replace H with its dual, we get that the line graph of that hypergraph is isomorphic to the two section of the dual. As an example of this, let's use our hypergraph and its dual from the last example. Here's the two section of the dual of our last hypergraph. And here's the line graph of the hypergraph. Notice that they're isomorphic. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. Have a great day.